Good morning, Matadors. I'm Dia.
And I'm Brayden. And this is your video El Aviso for Friday, November 3rd.
Hey, Matadors. Are you an artist or like being creative? Enter the library's design and sticker contest. The top two designs will be made into stickers that are available in the library, and runners up will receive a sticker of their design. All submissions are due today to Ms. Spence. Good luck.
Calling all AP students. If you want to take an AP test this spring, registration is now open. The late fee begins today. If your AP class starts next try, you can begin signing up now too. Please contact Ms. Spence in the library with any questions.
Now, we're going to take a look at some fun Halloween costumes this week.
What are you supposed to be?
Obama.
What are you going to do later tonight, this Halloween night?
Presidential duties.
What are you supposed to be this fine morning of Halloween?
A pregnant nun.
How do you feel being known as one of the popular snacks in the world?
It's great.
What are you going to name him or her?
Tyrone.
Tyrone, that's a nice name.
Who am I with today?
My name is Walter Hartwell White. I live at 308 Negro Oil Lane, Albuquerque, New Mexico, 87104.
Who are you dressed up as today?
It's me, Luigi.
Okay. Where's Mario?
Mario, she's going to English. Yeah.
She not sticking with you?
No, I thought we were bros, but I guess not. Fake.
That's so fake.
I know, right?
I am the danger.
What creative costumes. I love the spirit shown on campus.
Do you want free candy and extra credit? Want to improve your Spanish skills? Come to room P9 every Tuesday during lunch. If you have any questions, please contact Señora Gracia. We hope to see you there.
As the end of the trimester draws near, the art classes want to welcome anyone who wants to see student work to visit on Wednesday, November 15th. Come check it out.
Now, we're going to check out a new sports team on campus, flag football.
Everybody knows about football at Granada High School. It's everywhere. But a new set of players have stepped onto the field. I spoke with one of the players of the new Granada flag football team to see what sets them apart from the rest of the sports scene.
Flag pulled at about the 44.
I feel like an absolute beast because I am. No, but I'm actually really proud. And I feel like it's something that all the other girls should be proud of. And it's really good for this school, so go Granada.
Many of the players had wanted to play traditional football, but couldn't as it was mostly restricted to boys. Flag football has given them the opportunity to play football for their school, not just at Granada, but at all the other schools they play against.
The team works good, it's fun, it's a good environment. Our coaches are really good. They don't put up with lazy activity and chit chatter, so it's nice that they care about it as much as we do.
More and more people are going to games, showing an increase in interest with the sport. As well, many of the players plan on continuing to play in the coming years.
We're excited, we're ready, and yeah.
As they become more popular, it seems that flag football may start to have a real impact on the Granada sports scene as a whole. As it is, it seems that they're not going to leave anytime soon. That's all for me. Back to you, studio.
Glad to see those student-athletes starting strong.
Attention PE students. Lockers must be cleaned out and your lock removed when your final is over. Lockers that still have locks are cut and items donated.
Fall athletes, all sport lockers must be cleaned out by Friday, November 17th. This includes the varsity team room and locker room. Any locker with a lock on it after this date will be cut, and items will be donated.
Last but not least, we want to feature what Spanish classes are doing to celebrate Dia de los Muertos.
Who did you pick to do your ofrenda about and why?
We chose Chespirito because he's so inspirational
How are you going to express the cultural side of this project?
We're going to make an altar for Chisperito, and we're going to also make informative slides about the topic. That's all.
Why do you think it's important for students to do this project?
I think it's important for the students to do the project because it helps teach us about Latin America, American culture, and stuff like that.
I think it's important to teach my students about Dia de los Muertos because it's a cultural component. And it's a part of culture and history that has been forgotten for a lot of Latinos because a lot of that is our indigenous roots. And I think it's important that not only our Latino students, but also all the students learn a little bit about the indigenous roots.
What are some of your things on your altar and why did you choose them?
At the moment, we have food because you're supposed to include what the person who has passed likes to eat.
For that segment, back to you, studio.
What beautiful ofrendas. It is great that we can celebrate a strong tradition of culture and diversity here.
That's all for today, Granada.
Have a great day and stay classy.
My eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom. Vampire's feast, the ghouls all came.